Meanwhile, Korea will complete the indigenous development of an active electronically scanned array, or AESA radar, within the next decade. It's commenced the project with an eye on installing the AESA radar on its next-generation KFX aircraft by mid-2020s. Our defense correspondent Kim Hyun-bin explains what these radars are and how they stand out from the conventional ones.
Korea's state-run Agency for Defense Development has begun creating an active electronically scanned array radar, or simply known as AESA radar. The high-end device will be part of Korea's KFX project, which aims to develop 120 homegrown fighter jets by the mid-2020s. According to the Defense Acquisition Program Administration on Wednesday, the first prototypes of the radar will be ready by the second half of 2020, and added that starting the following year, the radar system will undergo a 5-year test run before being installed on KFX jets and becoming operational. Korea is investing $15 billion into the KFX fighter experimental project to replace its aging fleet of F-4s and F-5s.
This is the first time a radar system of this caliber is being developed in Korea, so we will need to bring in some foreign technologies. If the radar development does not meet technical standards despite being near completion, we will need to purchase the radar from other countries.
The AESA radar is less vulnerable to enemy jamming attempts, and it will be able to detect up to 20 fighter jets at once. Moreover, unlike previous radars operated by the Korean Air Force, the AESA can also detect simultaneously enemy ground vehicles and warships. The decision to develop its own radar system instead of purchasing it from other countries comes as the U.S. refused to transfer core technologies related to the radar system in April. Kim Hyun-bin, Arirang News.